Hey guys, so I'm so tired. It's April 27th and it's like 7 o'clock in the evening. I don't know, I was thinking about it. And I guess I had like hopes that I would have like a sense of direction with this channel. I know it's only been a week, but I don't really feel like I have a certain direction that I'm going in with it. I just want it to be really organic and really like impulsive and just very real. And I don't want it to be polished and like perfect and you know what I mean? Like I see these vlog channels and they look really cool because they're like perfect and everything, but I like my things to have like a sense of realness to them. So that's what I want for this channel. I want it to be very rugged and very, you know, like real. Like I want it to look like, I don't know, it's just the way I am. I also made it because I needed an outlet for my creativity, because you know I'm in college and I wait tables, so I don't really get to do much to release the creative energy that I have like within me. And I'm a very creative person, and I just needed some sort of outlet to do that. I also don't even live in the same city as my really good friends or like my family, so it's like I'm just, I have really really good friends here. I'm not gonna make it seem like I don't, because I met some amazing people while I'm living here. But I don't know, like I'm not near the things that I would like to be near, you know. Like I grew up by the water, you know, I grew up on the coast, I also grew up by the mountains, so that's home to me. Like I would love to just go hiking, I would love to go paddleboarding, go, you know, hang out at the beach all day, smell, you know, the salt in the air, hear the seagulls. Like that's what I would like to hear. Like I would love to just go and paint at the beach or something, you know. But closest beach to me is about 2 hours away. The closest nice beach to me, or decent, is like 5 or 6 hours, so I'm not really, I mean, granted we have Austin, it's like right here, but you know, I don't know, so this video didn't really have a direction to it. It's just, like I said, it's organic. Like I wanted it to just be impulsive, you know. I just was like, you know what, I might as well start recording. I don't know, that's just something that I really wanted to do. So I guess I'll start with like introducing myself and like who I guess I am as a person. So of course my name is Darren. I'm originally from San Diego, California. I went to high school, well, my part of high school in New Mexico, and then I moved to San Antonio, Texas, which is where I'm currently at right now, as soon as I graduated from high school. I was bullied a lot in high school, mostly because of my sexuality, and a lot of them didn't even really, they would bully me because I was gay, but I'm actually not gay, but I just thought it was funny. And I don't know, like, that's just, the city that my family live in right now, like my intermediate family, because a lot of my family lives in California, but my intermediate family, like my mom and my sisters and my grandparents, they live in New Mexico, and I hated it there. Like, I love visiting, I can't live there again. It's not for me. It just isn't for me. It's a beautiful state though, don't get me wrong, but I don't know, that's just really, it wasn't for me. So when, as soon as I had the chance, I took off and I came here, and I've been here since 2012, so 2016, so it'll be 4 years in October. But I came here for that reason, and I hated it for the first year and a half, 2 years, because as majority of you people in Texas know, it's nothing like California, not even close. So it was a very, very, very different for me. Also, the one thing that really bothered me was like we get a lot of people from Mexico, and that's not what bothered me. What bothered me was I get a lot of people from Mexico who expect me to speak Spanish because of my skin tone, and they would like, I had, my first job here was at Forever 21, and I actually had a lady yell at me because I didn't speak Spanish, and I was like, and I didn't know what to say, and I didn't really, like, understand, I understood a word or two because I took Spanish in high school, but one of my friends told me, and it was just like I didn't understand it, like why they were being that way. Like it didn't really make sense to me. But you know, San Antonio is like 2 or 3 hours away from the border, so it's not like it's a that far from there. And it's not even like that's a bad thing. I've never lived somewhere where people expect you to speak Spanish, so that was one thing that was kind of like weird to me. Another thing is, you know, I'm a vegetarian. If majority of you guys know, barbecue is like the big thing in Texas. Everybody wants to go hunting and kill things and eat it, and it's pretty barbaric in my eyes. And I'm the opposite, you know. I'd rather like save the trees, like save the whales, you know. I'm a vegetarian, like I said. I drive a Subaru, like I love being outdoors. Like I'm not, I don't know, that's just what I'm gonna change the song because it's like gonna be on repeat. But so it's just like the stuff that I like and the stuff that I'm into and all that stuff is just like complete, it's like the complete polar opposite here. So I try to go up to Austin as much as possible. I love Austin. Austin's like an hour from me. And it's beautiful. Like the people there are amazing. The city's beautiful. It's so vibrant there. Like there's so much life to it. And it's like, it's the closest thing that I can get to California, while being in Texas, because it's such a liberal city. So I don't know. I also go out of town a lot. Like I travel a lot only because I just, you know, like, I don't know, I have to travel, because if I don't get out of town, like, I feel like I lose my mind. Like, I can't just stay here constantly. Like, I only want to live here until I'm done with school, and then once I'm done with school, like, I'm gonna dip out, because this is just, it's not, but don't get me wrong, San Antonio is really cool. Like, the people here are really nice. The drivers are, they're okay, but there's a lot of stuff to do here also. It's just not for me. But I do enjoy living here and going to school here. That I'm going to say, because it is a really cool city. But I don't know. That's just where I'm coming from, and that's a little bit of information about me. I also... Okay, well, anyways, back to the high school thing. I was bullied a lot in high school, and when I moved here, I still wasn't even comfortable with my sexuality or anything, and being bisexual was really hard for me because I didn't know what I was. Like, I thought, there were some days that I thought I was gay, there were some days that I thought I was straight, like, I had no idea, because it's just, it's so conflicting within you, and then when you have people that are, like, asking if you're gay or whatever, and then, you know, your friends who you haven't come out to are saying you're straight, it's really... Not only is it conflicting within you, but then your outer surroundings are very conflicting as well. So it's like, I didn't know which way to turn. And I had no idea. Like, when I was going through this, I didn't think that you could like both. Like a good amount of people. Like, I had no idea. Like, I thought that you were either gay or you were straight. Like, I didn't know that there was like a bisexual or anything, you know? And it took me a while to figure it out. But when I moved here, I had a lot of people ask me if I was gay or if I was straight, and I didn't know how to answer it because, you know, I didn't know. Like, I had a lot of people that said my personality and the way that I acted came off as straight, but my voice came off as gay sometimes, and I was like I didn't know there was a certain way gay people spoke. Like, I didn't think that, I thought I was dumb. I didn't really know, and then I just started exploring with it and everything my first year, and I came to the conclusion that I liked both because I couldn't help the way that I felt about women, but I knew that I had an attraction to men. Like, I knew that I liked men and I knew that I liked women, but it just took me a while to figure it out. And last year, I was really comfortable with it, and I was, you know, I was at work, I was working at another restaurant, and one of my really good friends that was there, her name was Lakin, we would always talk about it and how I wanted to come out and all this stuff, but I didn't know how to do it, and I originally wanted to do it for Thanksgiving, like when I went back home, I wanted to tell them while I was there, but I don't know, I just, Something in me was like, I felt like I was hiding who I was and I was really tired of it, so I just made this long post on Facebook explaining everything, and then I just posted it, and then I was like, whatever, I'm done. Turned it off, went to sleep, woke up in the morning, and I had like tons of missed calls and text messages and like 100 plus Facebook notifications and like all this stuff, and I was like, oh, okay. So then I ate breakfast and I finally read it and everything, and everybody was really accepting of it. The hardest thing for me was my stepfamily, like a few people when I was growing up, I had heard them say, like, you know, bisexual people are just selfish because they want to sleep with everybody and all this stuff. Like, my stepdad's sister said that, and when I heard that, I was a freshman in high school or a sophomore in high school, and that was the first time I'd ever heard the term, and that was when I was still like, and that made me like internalize it even more and suppress my feelings because I didn't want to feel that way. And also coupled with, like, I had depression in high school, and I had a really, really bad depression episode while I was there, because I actually almost committed suicide twice. If it weren't for my best friends, I probably wouldn't be here, but I'm here, and I'm happy, and I'm good. I had a really bad depression episode this past December, and I went back home, and I stayed there for 2 months, and now I came back here, and I feel like refreshed, I feel good, I feel like better, I'm very driven now, like I know what I want to do and where I'm going and I know what goals I want to reach and all this stuff. I also started focusing on my fitness a lot more. I was really insecure and I lost like 40 pounds and I was finally content with that, and then I realized that I lost the weight, but what was I going to do next? And I had always like admired fitness models, bodies, like men's physical appearance in, you know, fitness magazines and stuff, and I had always like thought, I was like, oh, I wish I could look like that. So I decided that I was going to start working towards that, and I have been. I've gained 18 pounds so far, and that's really good to me because I'm happy with it. I go to the gym a lot, and I really just have been focusing on myself. Like, I don't really go out. I don't really hang out with anybody. I just do my own thing. Like, I love my friends. I text them all the time. I call them all the time. Like, I make sure that my friends know that I appreciate them and I want them there. And I do hang out with people when I get the chance. But it's always good to take a break from everything and just step back and just do your own thing, because we all need that, and it's not selfish. And if people think it's selfish, then honestly, you probably shouldn't have them in your lives, because we all have to do that. I mean, I even told my family that I wasn't going back for holidays this year because I need to focus on myself and do my own thing. So for Thanksgiving, I've decided that I'm gonna go take a trip somewhere, and for Christmas, I'm gonna go somewhere like Colorado or Wyoming or Montana. I don't know, but I'm gonna do something fun. And I just, this year, I'm gonna just focus on myself and do my own thing. And I think that that is something that we should all do and that we all need to do as part of our, like, soul-searching thing, especially if you're between the ages of, like, 18 and 25, 26. I'm barely 21, so I don't really know that far of age differences. But I know with me, like, I'm basically gonna put everything on this channel. Like that, okay, so how do I say this? I'm gonna say things and express my feelings a certain ways because I'm basically gonna say what I wanted to hear when I was like 16, 17, 18, up until maybe last year. So hopefully I get that age group within my channel. That way, you know, hopefully I could help some people through some things, because that would really mean a lot to me, because I enjoy helping people. But the most part, I'm pretty, like, positive influence on everybody. Of course, I mean, I get moody, everybody does, but that's what I'm trying to do. So I think that's all I have to say for today. So hopefully you guys have a really good day. I'm probably gonna go shower and go to bed because I'm really tired. But yeah, so hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you're still watching, thank you so much. Please subscribe, share my videos, you know, hopefully we can get more subscribers and more people to watch. All right. Thanks, guys. See you later.